Versatility of Peyton Royce.
I mean, even if nothing's torn over the stretch, that amount of pressure that keeps getting the fly, again, slowing down and taking that on problem.
Looks like she's taking it too lightly, though. You've got to get on her, Peyton. You're not going to get a lot of opportunities.
Oh! Right to the midsection, now Asuka. Oh! Suplex there to Peyton Royce. And Asuka taking a moment to recover, trying to revive the injured shoulder.
Damage done to Peyton Royce's back there. Question now becomes, what do we do at this point?
Count of five, both women after the count of ten to get back up to their feet.
Does she create some space? Does she get to the corner, lie in wait, play possum? Does she push the gas?
The only way to win the championship is by pinfall or submission.
You can't go toe to toe with strikes against Asuka. Gonna come up short.
The corner. Asuka for drop two.
What the money.
Oh! Oh! Here come the strikes.
Spinning back fist twice. There has been some damage done to that left shoulder.
Oh! There's the Shining Wizard. Went for it earlier on in the match. Cover it. Peyton Royce out of time.
That, to me, is the pedigree of a girl like Asuka. Let's take a look here. Shining Wizard right underneath the jaw. Straight back on top.
Oh, and a jawbreaker there by Peyton Royce. Trying to end Asuka's reign in 333 days. Oh! Well, look at this. Asuka with the cover. Out at one is Peyton Royce. Whoa! Peyton the cover of her own.
Here we go. Back to that shoulder.
Oh! Peyton Royce with the elbow run to the back of the neck to win the championship. Asuka kicked out in time.
That's close, though. You've got to follow up, Peyton. This is your opportunity. The champ is down. She is prone. The shoulder is injured. Take the opportunity now.
I gotta say, I am impressed at this moment with Peyton. She's giving Asuka a serious run.
I'd see what sort of submission she has in her repertoire. Looking for a Kimura, but instead, oh, she's trying for the bridge. Suplex.
Thought she won this opportunity. Oh, right on the face. Right on the face. This could be it. Asuka's reign. Kick out in time.
So close. Just bridging out from Asuka. Spinning heel kick. A lot of flexibility. Look how high she gets that foot up for the spinning heel kick. Peyton Royce has impressed me.
Oh! Royce knew what it would take to take out Asuka here tonight. And now Asuka!
Asuka lock,
middle of the ring. Peyton Royce all tied up. Get locked in.
Oh, no, she's going to have to
win. Asuka, your winner.
Here's your winner by submission and still NXT Women's Champion, Asuka.
With an injured shoulder, Asuka still managed to fend off the opponent.
Peyton Royce put a great shot. Oh, wait a second.
Wow, and Billy Kay taking out Asuka.
The vengeful. Femme Fatale comes to the aid of a tag team partner.
You're absolutely right. This is just revenge after this match.
These girls are mean.
Oh, and a kick again into the post.
More damage done to that injured shoulder.
No.
We're going to talk just a second.
Wait a minute.
Yes.
Amber Moon. Oh, Amber Moon takes out Billy Kay with one punch.
Now, as the medical staff looked at the injury, a surprise appearance from a former NXT superstar took place as Cassius Ohno checked on Nakamura backstage.
We were left with a lot of questions as NXT said goodbye to San Antonio last month. But let's show you what happened last week after the new NXT champion Bobby Roode was victorious in his match against No Way Jose. Jose again, talking up to the learning screen. You'll be back.
Deep shot on Jose.
Going after the leg. Oh, this is the way that...
Come on, Mr. Roode. Somebody stop.
Did all that damage on Nakamura in San Antonio. Come on.
Travels all over the world, 40 states, 20 countries, anything I have ever wanted, anything I've ever needed, I've reached out and I've taken it. And last time I was here, well, let's just say I've got some unfinished business. Bobby, you got what I want. You got what I need, that NXT championship.
That's a real touching story. That's a touching, sad story. But lucky for you, Mr. Ono, if that is your real name, you're looking at a fighting champion. And as far as I'm concerned, we don't have to wait. We can put this title on the line right here, right now. Take that jacket off. Let's get to work.
Oh, and Bobby Roode going after Ono's leg now.
Mistake by turning his back on Bobby Roode. He's a fighting champion. Oh, I know he's going to regret the day that he tested the glorious Bobby Roode.
I'm going to tell you something about Cassius Ono. I worked with this cat when I was here at NXT before. And when he gets his mind made up or something, he goes after it, he goes and gets it.
Cassius Ono is fighting back! Oh! Oh!
Hard-hitting strikes from Ono.
Oh, and Cassius Ono flopping Roode! Oh! Cassius Ono, a major statement to the champion!
Cassius Ono has finally returned to NXT and has unfinished business to take care of. And now let's take you to our general manager, William Regal, who is standing by with a huge announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, in light of recent events, I think it is only fitting that Bobby Roode defend his NXT championship for the first time. So, on March the 15th at the CFE Arena, Bobby Roode defend his NXT championship against Cassius Ono.
Cassius Ono has the opportunity of a lifetime as he looks to complete his unfinished business against the glorious NXT champion. Bobby Roode will put his title on the line against Ono in 2 weeks here on NXT.
This is our house of pain. We show no mercy. And if victory at all comes,
the championship action continues in our main event here tonight as Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa get their rematch for the NXT Tag Team titles against the undefeated Authors of Pain next.
My name is Wolfgang, I'm from Glasgow, Scotland. My dream was to become WWE champion, or at least work for the WWE. And over time, you see guys get places that you think you should be. And I kind of gave up hope. For the last 10 years, I've been working in a pub, which if you don't know, can be pretty rough. And wrestling kind of comes in handy when it comes to picking someone up and throwing them through the door.
What? 200
55-pounder!
And always to hug you, and always to beat you.
He knows what it takes to be a champion, a very decorated man.
If an opportunity comes up, and it's either win or lose, and I have to cheat to do it, I'm going to do it.
You gotta like the attitude of Wolfgang, the last king of Scotland.
Welcome back to NXT here at Paul Ciel University. And tonight, NXT is presented by Tad Bound Athletic Wear, available at Jason Bennett. And last week, we received the great news that the King of Strong Style, recovering from knee injury at NXT TakeOver San Antonio, was making progress. He began training in the WWE Performance Center last week. The great news continues because we have just learned that next week from the venue at CFB on the campus of the University of Central Florida, Nakamura will finally return to NXT. It is time for the NXT Tag Team Championship!
Tommaso Ciampa, Johnny Gargano. 2 weeks ago they asked for a title opportunity. Tonight they get one. But against the ferocious Authors of Pain, how big of an opportunity is that?
Gargano and Ciampa, their contractual rematch from San Antonio. They said a few weeks ago they saw something in the Authors of Pain. They saw doubt in San Antonio. They said they are not broken. They are ready to reclaim the titles. Percy, you can't question the heart of Gargano and Ciampa, but can they knock off these unbeaten monsters?
That I don't know, and I agree. You can never question their heart. These guys are two of the best tag team members in NXT history, of course, for Revival, but I just don't know what's going to happen when they face AOP tonight.
That's why, considering the way the Revival has instigated and antagonized the Authors of Pain, who knows what kind of frenzy Paul Ellering's whipped them into.
That's a great point. There is the erudite Paul Ellering. Bad intentions in his mind. And these are the men that can carry them out. Akim and Rezar, the Authors of Pain.
The winners of this year's Dusty Rhodes Tag Team Classic Tournament, undefeated, they march through the competition, Bulldoze DIY in San Antonio, to claim the titles.
Absolutely. Talking individuals, reckless, some would say ferocious.
Let's not forget about the instrumental Paul Ellering. That without him, maybe AOP would have had the title for him.
Or it certainly guided the monsters in the right direction.
The following contest is a tag team match scheduled for 1-4. And it is for the NXT Tag Team Championship! Introducing the challengers, at a combined weight of 400 pounds, Johnny Gargano, Tommaso Ciampa, DIY! And their opponents, at a combined weight of 615 pounds, they are